Hey everyone, I'm Ruth. Welcome back to another video. In this tutorial, I'll be showing you how to paint a peony in watercolor. I'll be showing you how you can paint this peony really realistically by adding many layers. I'll also show you how to paint the details in. So let's get right into the tutorial. I start by taping my paper to the surface. Then I mix my purple and pink colors on my palette and start by painting in a light layer on my paper. I pre-wet the petals and then I apply a light layer of paint. I lift off some of the pigment with a damp brush. These are the highlights in the petals. I make sure that I start with my petals that are not touching each other, because if the petals are touching each other, the paint will bleed into the next petal. So I chose a petal that's not close to the previous one. And when this is dry, I can start on a petal next to this one, as you can see me doing here. So for this first layer, I repeat the process in every petal. So adding a layer of light diluted paint, then lifting off some of the pigment for the highlights with a damp brush with only a little bit of water on it. And then the next petal, repeating the whole process. As I mentioned before, the paint is very diluted in this stage, so I add a really light layer of the lightest values to all of the petals at first. Lifting off some of the pigment again for the highlights, and adding some more color. So, wetting the paper, adding a light layer of paint, and then lifting off some of the pigment. I use my black velvet silver brushes for this painting on Arches hot pressed watercolor paper. So now I add my first layer of green to the stem of the peony and to the leaves as well. And I do the same here as I did on the petals, adding a light layer of diluted paint and then using a damp brush to lift off some of the pigment for the highlights. So when that layer is dry, I add another layer of paint, and this time it is a little less diluted, darker purple for the shadow areas. And as you can see, I use the tip of my brush to create really fine lines and detail to the petals. Then again, a damp brush to lift some of the pigment again to create smooth transitions from the highlights to the shadows. I repeat this process on all of the petals, adding a darker layer of paint to create some detail already. And as you can see, I'm slowly building up my layers, starting with very diluted paint. And with each layer, I use a little less diluted paint, thicker paint, And by adding all these different layers, I create a lot of depth. And that makes the painting look really realistic. So here I add a really dark purple to the shadow areas. And also some shadow to the petals as well. Using thicker paint again, not so diluted anymore. And then lifting off some of the pigment with my damp brush. Creating fine lines here with my smallest brush, with a little bit of water on it. And some more shadow here to the petals. And then creating the lines with my damp brush to create all of the fine detail. I add a light layer of paint. Then I wait until this paint has slightly dried. And then I go in with my damp brush to lift off some of the pigment. If you want to see more of my artwork and learn how to paint and draw yourself, you can head over to my Patreon page. I'll put a link down in the description box. Here you'll find a lot of in-depth tutorials, real-time videos, reference photos to print out for your own artwork, tips and tricks videos, art materials, and a lot more. So I hope to meet you there. So when that layer has dried, I mix some green on my palette, some dark green, and I add that to the stem of the peony and to the leaves as well, to the shadowed areas. And I use my tiny brush for this, black velvet silver brush, the round brush, adding this darker green to all of the shadowed areas. Some more shadow, more darker purple on the leaves, and I use a soft tissue here to create some shadow and highlights that look really natural. Then adding some more detail with the same technique that I explained before. And I repeat this process over and over again, adding many layers to create depth to my peony and create a really realistic look. And as I always say, patience is key when creating realism. Adding these many layers, light layers, and building up the values is really important in realism. So here I add a really dark purple to create the darkest shadows, and also some darker pink to create some more detail. All of the shadow areas, I add this darker purple color. Slowly building up my layers. And another layer to the stem and the leaves. And with my smallest brush, I paint in the veins on the leaf now, with a dark green color. Looking closely at my reference photo to create that realistic look. And some dark green to the inside of the leaf. And some more shadow to the stem as well. And using the dark green color, to add all of the shadows to the other leaves as well. Adding all of the veins and all of the details, paying close attention to my reference photo to make sure that I paint in all of the detail correct. Some more shadow here. I'm being very careful with these darker colors because with watercolor it's really hard to correct mistakes. So that's another reason that I paint with many layers, building up the values really slowly, because that makes it easier to correct any mistake. So more darker purple to the shadow areas. And you can see that makes the peony really pop and make the colors really vibrant, defining all of the petals by adding more darker purples. And as you can see, these darker values also make the lighter petals stand out. And I keep adding detail until I'm happy with how my peony is looking. Adding some more shadow here, again to define all of the details and the other petals as well. Creating smooth transitions. And then I'm adding some more detail to this little petal here, some more pink, and I paint in really tiny little dots with the tip of my brush, and some more shadow to the leaves as well. And then when that layer has dried, I add some more shadow, some really dark purple. Really dark colors, and the paint is not so diluted anymore. It's much thicker than the first layers. Adding some more tiny lines. And some more shadow as well, using my smallest brush to create all of the fine detail. And to blend my colors, I just use a little bit of water on my brush, so I add a layer of paint. And then I put some water on my brush, just a tiny little bit, and I use this to blend the colors to create that really smooth transitions, defining the veins a little more and adding some more detail, some more shadow as well, really defining all of the details here by adding more color. Now I add another layer of paint to the veins, some thicker paint, and some more shadow to the stem as well. And when I'm happy with how my peony is looking, I'm ready to take off the tape. Thank you very much for watching my video. If you liked it, please give me a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Hit the notification bell to get informed when a new video comes out. You can leave a comment down below and don't forget to share my video with all your friends. You can also follow me on Facebook and Instagram. Thank you. Bye.